Good morning, students. Today we'll be continuing our previous topic, which was plant nutrition. So before we move into this part, you should be able to differentiate the different layers of the leaf, all the different types of cells which are present in the leaf, and you should also know about photosynthesis, why the plants do photosynthesis and what is the importance of photosynthesis. Other than that, you should also know that what are the raw materials. Raw materials means what are the things required to do photosynthesis. Okay, so I will not go into the detail of the previous lecture, so try to revise that and then come to this part of the lecture. Okay, here in the diagram they have shown two types of cells, palisade cells and spongy cells. You can see they have given the arrows as well, and you can see the difference between them easily because the above structure, palisade one, is rectangular in shape and the lower one is circular in shape. That's why they are different from each other and they are present at different places in the leaf. The other very important part of the plant cell is the chloroplast. Okay, think of chloroplast as a balloon and it is filled with water, and this water is basically the chemical chlorophyll. Okay, chlorophyll. Think of the chloroplast as a balloon filled with water, and in case of chloroplast, that water is basically chlorophyll. Okay, so chloroplast contains chlorophyll, which is a chemical which produces oxygen through photosynthesis. So actually photosynthesis happens because of chlorophyll. Okay, so we will move to step by step process which is happening in the cell when photosynthesis is about to happen. Okay, how photosynthesis happens. So here they have given bullet points, but you will write 1, 2, 3. So you should know the sequence and you should know how, what are the raw materials and how the process happens. When carbon dioxide and water enter the cell traps light energy using chloroplast. The energy is used to split water into hydrogen and oxygen. So here they have given the formula of water as well. So light energy is used to split, means to break this into hydrogen, two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. Okay, so many water molecules are used to split, are split by the light energy from the sun. Okay, moving to the next step. Okay, fourth step is oxygen is excreted out the leaf to the atmosphere. So oxygen is a waste gas which the plant excretes out into the atmosphere, and the hydrogen which is left from the water molecule reacts with carbon dioxide, which also plants get from the atmosphere to form glucose molecule. Okay, so here is the equation. First one is the symbol equation, the lower one is the word equation. So write both of this and the previous paragraph as well with the diagram, because they are really important. So in the last paragraph, here they have just explained that how carbon dioxide basically enters the leaf. So it enters through the process which I already discussed, that is diffusion. And you should also revise this, that how diffusion causes the air molecules from move from higher to lower side. So you already know that. So carbon dioxide moves from higher concentration to a lower concentration, which means from atmosphere, which is in which it is in a higher concentration, and moves into the leaf where it is in low concentration. Okay, down the concentration gradient. So make sure you write all of this information. If you have any confusion, directly send me a voice note and I will answer your question. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.